Hello kiddos, welcome back to the math session. Kids, in previous video we saw 24-hour clock. Yes, and today we are going to have a new topic. That is, we are going to see how to calculate the time gap or the time elapsed or the duration between the starting point, starting time and the ending time. Okay, so let's begin with an interesting example. Now, in this example, kids, I am going to school and I am leaving my house at 7 a.m. Fine. So, 7 a.m. is my starting time. And I am reaching the school at 8 a.m. So, 8 a.m. is my finishing time. So, can you tell me the duration of my traveling? Yes? Can you tell me how much time I have spent in the traveling? On the road? Yes, it's 1 hour. So, the duration is 1 hour. So, that's it. We are going to apply this same logic in the whole session. Okay. Now, the calculation was very easy because it was only 1 hour. Now, let's take one difficult example. Okay. Now, here, Emily had a soccer practice after school today. Fine. And the green clock, this clock shows the time of the starting time of the practice, that is 3 o'clock. And the practice ends at 6:30. Fine. So, you have to find how much time did Emily spend in soccer practice today. The starting point is 3 and the ending time is 6:30. So, the time elapsed or the duration you have to find. Okay, so let's start. Now from 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock, it will be 1 hour. Okay, so I have written here 1 hour. From 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock, again a 1 hour. From 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock, again a 1 hour. Okay, and from 6 o'clock to 7 o'clock, it's 1 hour. But it's 6:30 here. So 6 o'clock to 6:30, it will be only 30 minutes. Fine. So in all, she have the practice for 1 hour, then 1 hour, then again a 1 hour, then 30 minutes. So in all she had practice for 3.5, that is 3 hours and 30 minutes. So my final answer will be Emily spent 3 hours 30 minutes in the soccer practice today. Fine. Now moving on to more difficult calculation. Here it is easy because it is a perfect timing given to you. Okay, 1 hour, 30 minutes, 15 minutes. So it will be easy. But we have to calculate the exact minutes. Fine. And then we have to have the answer. Okay, let's take one more example. It will be more clearer to you. Okay, now Rohit boarded the bus at 6:45 a.m. Fine. See, in initial examples we didn't had a.m. and p.m. Fine. Here we are taking a.m. and p.m. So Rohit boarded the bus at 6:45 a.m. and got down at 9:20 a.m. In the morning 6:45 and in the morning 9:20. Okay. How much time did he spend on the bus? So, what we will do is, we will have the starting point, okay, the starting time, and then we will have the hour after the starting point. Now, it is 6:45 a.m. So, after 6:45, which will be the hour following hour, it will be 7 a.m. Okay, after 15 minutes, it will be 7 a.m. And then we will find how are the hour before finishing time. See, this is the finishing time, 9:20. So, the exact hour before the finishing time is what? I can say 9 a.m. Yes? Okay. Then we will find the finishing point. The finishing point is exactly what? 9:20 a.m. So, this is the trick we are going to follow. We are going to have four different times. Okay. That is the starting time, then the following hour, and the hour before the finishing time and the finishing time. Fine. So, here we will have a presentation like this. The first point is a starting point, 6:45 a.m. And the second point is the following hour, that is 7 a.m. So in between, how much time is there? 6:45, say like 7 o'clock. How much time is there? It's 15 minutes. Okay. Then we will find the following, the hour before finishing time. So the finishing time is 9:20, which is the hour before finishing time. It's 9 a.m. So we'll cross down like this. Okay, from the 2 point, we'll come down to the 3rd point. And between 7 to 9 a.m., what is the time elapsed? What is the time gap? The time gap is 2 hours because 7 a.m., 8 a.m. and 9 a.m. So it's 2 hours. And then we will have the finishing point, that is 9:20 a.m. So what's the time gap or the time elapsed between 3 and 4? 9 o'clock and 9:20, it's 20 minutes. Yes. So in all, I can say that Rohit has traveled 15 minutes from here, 2 hours and 20 minutes. Okay. So in all, Rohit has traveled, you can say, this much. Yes, he has traveled this much. Okay. So in all, he has traveled 2 hours 35 minutes. So 2 hours 20 minutes plus 15 minutes will give me 35 minutes. So my final statement will be Rohit spent 2 hours 35 minutes on the bus. Clear with it? Okay. Now let's move on to the next example. Mrs. Jane reached the supermarket at 11:20 a.m. and left at 2:52 p.m. Now see, it's a.m. and it's p.m. Now it's afternoon. Okay. How much time did she spend at supermarket? That's the question. Now we will follow the trick. We will have the starting time, then the following hour, the hour before the finishing time, and then the finishing time. Okay. So let's have the representation. Starting point is 11:20 a.m. and the following hour will be after 11:20, which hour it will come? It will be 12 noon. Okay. So the time gap between these two timings will be 40 minutes because 11:20, yes. So 20, say 30 is 10 minutes and 40 is 20 minutes. 50 is 30 minutes and then 60, that is 12 noon, will be 40 minutes. Okay, so here it's 40 minutes. Now the third point is hour before finishing time. So what's the hour? What's the finishing time? It's 2:52 p.m. So the hour before 2:52 p.m. is 2 p.m. Okay, so from 12 to 2 p.m. we will have 2 hours left. So this is how we will come to the hour before finishing time. And then the last, we have to find the finishing time. So the finishing time is 3:52 p.m. So, here it's 2:52, okay? It's 2:52. So it will be 52 minutes only. So in all, I can say that in all, Mrs. Jane has spent this much time in the market, that is 40 minutes, okay, 2 hours and 52 minutes. Now let's check out 52 minutes and 40 minutes. You will add up because they are minutes, okay, and 2 hours you will keep it separately. So let's add the minutes because the minutes are too big. Okay, so 52 minutes plus 40 minutes will give me 92 minutes. Now 92 minutes, we have 1 hour will be 60 minutes and 32 minutes. So I have bifurcated as hour and minutes. Fine, because 60 minutes will complete 1 hour. So I'll have 1 hour and 32 minutes. So my final answer will be 2 hours already she has spent plus this 1 hour, that is 3 hours and 32 minutes. Are you getting it? Yes. So let's have the final statement. Mrs. Jane spent 3 hours 32 minutes at the supermarket. Clear with it? Okay. Now moving on to the next question. The starting time is given to you as 1:45 p.m. and the end time is given to you as 3:30 p.m. And you have to find the elapsed time. Elapsed time means the time gap. Okay. So let's have our rule. We'll find the starting time, then the hour following hour, then the hour before the finishing time and the finishing time. Okay. And we will have the representation. Okay. Now this I have represented on the number line. Fine, you can do this way also, or the way, or the previous way which I have taught you. Any which ways which is comfortable to you, you can follow that. Okay. Now the starting point is 1:45 p.m. and the following hour is 2 p.m. The hour before the finishing time, so this is the finishing time. 3:30 is the finishing time. The hour before that is 3 p.m. So these are the four points which we are going to consider. Okay. And then we will find the time between the four points. Okay. So from 1:45 p.m. to 2 p.m. we have 15 minutes. From 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. we have 1 hour. And from 3 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. we have 30 minutes. Fine. Now again I am going to combine all the minutes. Okay. So it is 15 minutes plus 30 minutes, which will give me 45 minutes. Fine. So the time elapsed is 1 hour and 45 minutes. Okay. Now moving on to the exercise 12.3. The first question: the Howrah New Delhi Duronto Express leaves Howrah at 12:40 p.m. Okay. Now this is the name of the train which leaves Howrah. Howrah is a place in West Bengal, or okay, and it leaves the at 12:40 p.m. and reaches Delhi at 5:35 a.m. the next day. Now be careful here. It's starting in the evening, means in the afternoon at 12:40 p.m. and it is reaching Delhi at 5:30 a.m. the next day. So almost there will be a traveling of 12 hours plus 12 hours. The next day it's going. Okay. So I am guessing that 12 hours ka to minimum journey hoga. 12 hours se zyada hoga. Fine. So what is the duration of the journey? So what we'll do? We'll have our four major points. That is the starting point. The starting time is 12:40 p.m. The hour after the starting point will be, after 12:40 p.m. what will be the hour? 1 p.m. Then we will have the hour before the finishing time. So finishing time is 5:30 a.m. So hour before it will be 5 a.m. and the finishing time will be 5:35 a.m. So this is the major four points. Now the only thing we have to do is we have to find the time gap between the four points. Okay. So we will have our representation. Okay. Starting point is 12:40 p.m. and the hour is, following hour is 1 p.m. So the time gap between this is 20 minutes. Okay. Now that's the major turning point now. Okay. The time is 1 p.m. and the hour before the finishing time is 5 a.m. but the next day. See, this is very important. The next day. Okay. So from 1 p.m. to 5 a.m. that is the next day, it will be 16 hour, because 1 p.m. to 1 a.m. it will be 12 hours, then 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 12 plus 4 will give me 16. Okay. So you calculate the time lapse between 1 a.m. and 1 p.m. and 5 a.m. It will give you 16 hours. And from 5 a.m. to 5:35 a.m. it will be 35 minutes. So in all, train has traveled 20 minutes, 16 hours and 35 minutes. The red marked. Fine. So we will have 20 minutes, 16 hours and 35 minutes. And we will add all the minutes. It will give us 55 minutes. 16 hours and 55 minutes. So only 5 minutes is left for 1 hour. Okay. So my final statement is, what is the duration of the journey? So I'll write the duration of the journey on which train? Howrah New Delhi Duronto Express. This is the train's name. Okay. Is 16 hours and 55 minutes. Fine. So the person traveling in this train will sit from the West Bengal in the Howrah station at 12 hours 40 p.m. and will travel 16 hours 55 minutes and reach to Delhi at 5:35 a.m. the next day. Okay. With this, I am giving you the exercise 12.3 as your homework. Okay. All the concepts are being cleared in this video and you will be able to solve the exercise very easily. I hope you will complete your homework on time. Thank you.